It's The Tonight Show with Jay Leno, featuring Kevin Eubanks and The Tonight Show Band. And me, I'm Ed Hall. Tonight, Jay welcomes Will Ferrell, Fear Factor's Joe Rogan, the music of Robert Randolph and the Family Band, and Idiots for a Day. And now, Jay Leno.
You sound like Bill Clinton when he heard silicone breast implants were coming back. Yeah! Well, congratulations to the New York Yankees. They're going to the World Series. Yeah. Let me tell you something. Yankee coach Don Zimmer was so happy he threw himself to the ground. Just boom. How many watch a game? Did you watch last night? Huge game. Yeah, yeah. I tell you, I was disappointed. I wanted the Red Sox to win.
All right.
You know, I'm from Boston. But you know something? I thought this was really nice. Today, Rush Limbaugh donated all his leftover painkillers to the city of Boston. Isn't that nice? And there was enough for everybody. I tell you something, everything was going great for Boston until, what, the 11th inning, when that Cubs fan showed up wearing a Red Sox cap. That threw the whole thing off. See, everybody's wondering, what if that Cubs fan hadn't touched the ball the other night? What if? Would everything have changed? Well, let me tell you something. With the help of space-age technology, we can actually show you what would have happened.
Really?
I'm going to show you what would have happened if that man, if he hadn't done... Well, here, take a look. Game six. Now watch. See, he's not there. It hits the rail. That man is being called a hero today.
Oh, yeah. Not in Chicago.
So it's going to be the Yankees and the Florida Marlins. You know what that means? That means 72-year-old Marlins manager Jack McKeon, he's going to the World Series. And even though he's 72, women seem to like him. He's like a sex symbol now. Did you see what happened the other night during the press conference when he got that booty call? Take a look. Hold on.
Who is it?
Hello?
Who's calling, Jack?
You know me.
It has been unusually hot in Los Angeles this week. What was it, 90, 91 degrees today? It was so hot today, Kobe Bryant called room service just to get some ice. That's how hot.
It's
looking better for Kobe.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I'm not saying the case against Kobe is getting weak, but I heard today Kobe started dating again. Yeah. So. Well, have you heard the latest? You heard the latest what's going on? It turns out that the DNA sample found in the girl's underwear was not Kobe's. They said it was a white guy's DNA. Come on, a white guy at a ski resort in Colorado? I don't think so. What are the odds of that? No, but because of all these allegations against Kobe, there's now talk of bringing in a so-called choking expert. Come on, haven't the Chicago Cubs suffered enough? I don't know why. They should be dragged into this. It's not their fight. And here's some good news. The Chinese astronaut that took off this week is back on Earth after 21 hours in space. Ooh, 21 hours. Ooh. Hey, I've been on Southwest flights from Burbank to Reno. Took longer than that. 21 hours. Ooh, 21 hours. And speaking of that, this is kind of scary. Today, three suspicious bags filled with clay-like material, bleach, and box cutters were found on two Southwest Airlines planes in New Orleans and Houston. That's the bad news. That's the bad news. The good news, we have been so successful in cutting off the terrorist funding, they're now forced to fly southwest. So that's good. So that's good. That's the good news. Now it's time for the Friday stupid joke of the day.
Uh-oh.
There's always like one stupid joke.
Okay.
I'm telling you ahead of time, so I don't want to hear any complaints that this is a stupid joke.
Okay.
National Security Advisor Condoleezza Rice got in a little trouble today when she referred to President Bush's stop in Japan as a layover. She called it a layover, which angered the Japanese. In fact, they were so mad, they were steamed at Rice. That's how you say it. Don't yell at me. You could have left during the joke. I said it's going to be stupid. And, you know, here's more proof that President Bush is in complete control of the White House. You know, I want to show you this in the paper. This is the Philadelphia Inquirer. This is your hometown paper. Yeah. Why don't you read this quote? I think this is wonderful. Can you get in tight there? Mm-hmm. It says, President Bush told his senior aides Tuesday he didn't want to see any more stories quoting unnamed administration officials in the media anymore. And if he did, there would be consequences, said administration official who asked that his name not be used. And it's now being reported, how stupid is this? Tom Arnold, we love Tom Arnold.
Fine,
now saying
too.
Tom Arnold may run for governor of Iowa. I guess he got turned down for the center position on Hollywood Square. I guess that didn't work out. See, I don't know if Tom's right for governor. I see him more as the governor's embarrassing brother. That's who he should be playing. Not really the actual governor. And this Sunday, the Pope will beatify. Is that the word? Beatify Mother Teresa, which means she's just one miracle short of sainthood. So if the Red Sox had won last night, she could have had it. Here you go. And here you go. Any Canadians here? No. Mike, you're not Canadian. Shut up. Well, here's an odd story. General Motors has had to change the name of their new car, the Buick LaCrosse, for the Canadian market. Because in French-speaking Quebec, LaCrosse is a slang term for masturbation. Isn't that funny? You know, General Motors changed the name of the cars because they sound... How about getting rid of Hummer? Okay, let's get rid of that name. We've got to get names. Please. Please. And according to a new study, internet technology has reduced Los Angeles' share of the pornography market. Los Angeles used to have 90% of the pornography business. Now we have just 70%. Can't we keep any jobs in the state? Even the porn people, that's it. I'm going to Utah. And according to the American Society of Reproductive Medicine, marijuana use may decrease fertility in men. And you know guys are going to jump all over this study, huh? Honey, I don't need a condom. I'm on the bond. Here's something I read in the paper today. A bar in New York City is selling a martini for $63. $63 martini.
Whoa.
And the general manager says it's a way to reward yourself after a hard day's work. You know, if you weren't spending 63 bucks in a drink, maybe you wouldn't have to work so hard. And according to the Wall Street Journal, I never heard of this. Maybe you heard of this. The new trend in bars now is drinks with bits of food in them. You heard about this? Like cocktails that have like blue cheese and cucumbers and pieces of ham in them.
Ew.
Alcohol with food in it. Didn't that used to be called vomit? I'm sorry. Am I wrong here? That vomit? What is that? Ew, food in it. Horrible that is. Horrible thing of that is. Oh, here's the story. Oh, I love this. Wait to see this. One of our sister stations, WRC-TV, in Washington, D.C., was doing a story about smoking in bars. So they went to... You know, this is a big issue with people. So they went to a bar to stand in the bar and talk about the story. And one guy didn't seem to like the story. But watch. See, this is why a cameraman is so important on a live shoot. Watch how the cameraman deftly moves the camera away from what's happening over the right shoulder of the female reporter. Look to the right shoulder. Watch how the cameraman slowly gets out of it. Take a look.
Now, there has been some confusion over who this law applies to. Some bars and restaurants in Rockville thought they were affected.
Steady she goes, helmsman. Just slowly move the camera. And according to the latest issue of Glamour magazine, which is my Bible, obviously, The hottest fashion trend for women now is tattooing words on their rear ends. Have you heard about this? I think the most popular words, objects are smaller than they appear. I believe that's the big, one. And finally, have you heard about this? The latest cure for women with low sex drive is the testosterone patch. They give women testosterone. Unfortunately, once the women get their sex drive back, the men lose theirs because the women are going, come on, let's do it. I'm on the patch. Come on, you want to do it? Yeah, yeah, come on. Well, we'll be right back with our idiot for a day and the very funny Will Ferrell. Say hello to Kevin Eubanks and the Tonight Show. Welcome back. Ladies and gentlemen, all of us at one time have done some stupid things that we're embarrassed about, something that made us look like complete imbeciles. Now, while most people just bury these things deep in their subconscious and pay for it years later, we have in our audience three brave souls who will come forward and tell us how they were idiots for a day. All right. Let's meet our first idiot. Where's Tracy Barr? Hello, Tracy.
Hi.
Hi, Trace. Where are you from?
San Diego.
San Diego, California. What do you do down there?
I'm a police officer.
Oh, a police officer. Oh, okay. How long have you been on the force?
4 years.
4 years. Okay. Now, what, you did something that made you idiot for a day?
Well, as most of y'all probably noticed, I have a rather large asset.
You know, I hadn't really known. I mean, do you make that a practice to point that out to people?
I don't have to.
I mean,
point
you
it
seem
out.
Like a very attractive woman. I can't say
fair.
That I am. Well, all right.
With that in mind, yeah. My partner and I had arrested a guy for DUI, so yeah. We were transporting him downtown to headquarters for further processing.
Right.
And as we get down there, it's a typical Saturday night. It's packed with other prisoners, officers, police cars.
Right.
So my partner pulls into this very tight spot, parking spot.
Yeah.
So he gets out of the car, no problem.
Yeah.
I, on the other hand, had a problem. I get the door open probably about that much, and as I try to get out, I get stuck. Yeah.
I see it's starting to make sense now. Yeah. So.
I need to get some of those tattoos.
And you got stuck?
Yeah, I got stuck. So, in the meantime, the prisoner in the car next to us is dying laughing at me.
Yeah.
That's not helping his case,
no.
Really, no.
And so, like, then my prisoner starts laughing at me, so my coolness has just been
lost. Right, right.
So, at that time, everyone's staring at me at this point. So, finally, here I am stuck in the door, and I just yell at my partner. I'm like, Steve, get back in the car and back this thing up. So, as soon as we get back in, start backing up, I start hearing everyone go, dee, dee, dee.
Well, it's actually very nice. But look, we're sorry. We have a little gift for you in case that ever happens again. This is WD-40. This is their 50th anniversary. So you just, what you do, you just spray a little of this back there, and I think that'll work out fine for you. Well, thank you. Thank you, Trey. Thanks for being a good sport. All right. Where's Frederick Slagstrom? Am I saying that right? Frederick. Hi, Frederick. How are you?
I'm very fine, thank you.
Oh, no. Now, where are you from? It sounds like you're in the Woodland Hills?
No, Borlänge, Sweden.
Oh, Sweden. Oh, yeah. You're from Sweden. Oh, what are you? Oh, that's cool. Well, nice to have you here.
Nice to be here.
How long have you been here?
We've been here almost for 1 week. We're going to be here two more, so.
You're going to be here two more? So
yeah,
it'll be 3 weeks?
Yes.
3 weeks. All right. And what do you do back home?
I'm a mailman.
Oh, mailman.
Yeah.
Okay, deliver mail. Okay.
Yeah.
And you did something that made you an idiot for day, Swedish edition.
Yeah, I'm still...
Still idiot for
yes.
A day, okay. All right, well, what, you seem normal enough.
Yeah.
Have you met some American women? Yeah.
No.
Really?
Not except for my relatives, so.
Maybe. Now, what do you think of the American women? Nice, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. All right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, well, go ahead. Maybe your story, someone will take pity on you and go home and have sex with you. Okay. Well, let's find out. Go ahead.
It was a new day for me, and I was driving a new route. Yeah, and I got a new mail car.
A mail car? Oh, like a postal car?
Yeah. It was only like 10 days old.
10 days old. Brand new postal vehicle.
I was like the first one to drive it almost.
Wow, okay.
So, and I was... This was 3 years ago, so I'm in a hurry. I want to be fast.
You want the mail to get there on time.
Yeah, but...
See, you should come work for our post office. But go ahead. Yeah. All right, so you want to get the mail there on time.
Yeah, so, but suddenly before me, I see this huge tractor with, like, a crane on it.
Yeah.
Working, blocking my way, and I'm like, I gotta get past
this. You have to deliver the mail.
Yeah, I'm in a hurry. So, I think, if I go slowly, I might get under it. Get under the crane, you know?
Yeah, I see why I don't have a date. All right, go ahead. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah.
So I slowly drive the car, yeah, and suddenly just bam, and I'm stuck there under the crane.
You got stuck under. Did you damage the car?
Yeah. They start to pull the crane up slowly, and I start to drive too fast.
Right.
So the whole roof got.
They ripped the roof off the new car.
It was on, but it was. Oh, pretty damaged, yeah.
Pretty damaged.
Yeah.
I'd imagine in Sweden a convertible is really a desirable thing. All right, look, well, we have something for you, since you're an idiot for a day. This is, since you are an immigrant,
yeah,
and you're in America, from Governor Gray Davis, this is your own California driver's license. Okay, there you are.
Thank you.
California driver's license. Good luck. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Thank you, Marty.
All right, we have time for one more. Marty Pivnik.
Stay here.
Hi, Marty. How are you?
Very well.
Marty, where are you from?
I'm from Toronto, Canada.
Toronto, Canada. Well, welcome, welcome. Nice to have you here. What do you do up there?
I'm a lawyer.
Oh, a lawyer. All right, get out. No, I'm sorry. You're a lawyer. Now, what brings you down here? Just on holiday?
Just the holidays. I was here for a wedding.
Now, in Canada, do you go on a holiday, or is it like England where you go on holiday?
On a holiday.
On a holiday. All right. Now, what did you do that made you an idiot for a day?
I was at a Toronto Blue Jays baseball game.
Okay.
And I had my glove.
Mm-hmm.
And
you brought your glove to the game?
I always do
today. You're 11 now, I believe? Okay. Yeah.
And there was a pizza promotion, and if I was able to catch 3 fly balls, which were shot out of a cannon into the field,
right,
I would get a free piece of pizza for every fan in the stadium.
What, how many people in the stadium?
About 40,000.
40,000. So 40,000 people's slice of pizza depended on you.
On me.
That's a tremendous responsibility.
Right. It certainly is.
Well, how did you do?
I caught 2, dropped 1, was booed roundly, and nobody got pizza.
Oh. Well, you know something, we believe everybody in life deserves a second chance. Okay, now in our audience, everyone in our audience will get a slice of pizza if you can catch 3 balls that we pitched to you. Okay? Here's the glove. Here you go. Here's the glove right here. All right? Now, everyone, this is your chance. You know, people wish they had a say. Oh, if I could go back, I would have married that girl. Oh, I should have done this if I hadn't dropped. But here's your chance. Are you nervous?
Very nervous.
Very nervous. All right, look. I'll tell you what. You come right out here. Now, what you do is you have to catch 3, and everyone, we have the pizza standing by. Everyone will get a slice of pizza if you catch all 3. All right, ready? On the count of 3, Joey, here comes the first ball. 1, 2, 3. A cone! Oh, my God! Oh, a Cubs fan! Oh, you idiot! All right, get out! Get out! Get out! So sorry. I am so sorry that... Stupid Cubs fan! I feel so bad about this. We're going to give everybody a slice of pizza anyway. Pizza, everybody. All right, thank you, buddy. Thank you very much. How you doing there? Thanks, you guys. Thanks, Frederick. Thanks, Chase. Be right back with Will Farrell right after this. Pizza eaters. Actor and comedian Will Ferrell joining us in just a minute. Also, Fear Factor's Joe Rogan is here with another one of these bug-eating tapes. This one is like the most disgusting one you'll ever see. So you stay tuned for that. And Robert Rudolph and the Family Band will perform as well. Next week, Saturday, October 25th, I'll be at Washington State University in Pullman, Washington. You're up there. Come. Hey, why? Thank you very much. I'll give you a lift up after the show. All right, let's get right to it. My first guest, you know him from his work, of course, Saturday Night Live, in addition to movies like Zoolander, my favorite. You have to rent Zoolander. This is a great comedy, very funny, and of course, old school, another terrific comedy. His latest film is called Elf. It opens everywhere on November 7th. Please welcome Will Farrell, ladies and gentlemen. A regular standing ovation is one thing.
Wow.
These people. They just had pizza and they stood up.
They're still digesting.
Exactly.
Yeah. Let's go streaking. I'll go with you 3.
There you are.
Huh? Wait, where's the Swedish mailman?
Over there, Swedish mailman over there.
Hey, Mora. Jag älskar kyckling.
I just said I love chicken. My wife's Swedish, so.
Ah.
Just a little tidbit. Yeah.
Hey, maybe they know each other.
Do you know the Pollens? Never mind. We'll talk about it later. Jay.
Yes?
I was watching your show.
All right.
On Tuesday, where you had the lovely Miss Heidi
Klum.
Klum.
With the $11 million bra.
With the $11 million bra and matching underwear.
Right.
And, you know, I'm actually wearing something quite similar that I'd like to show off.
Wow.
This is actually, this is worth about $4.
Wow. The family jewels on it?
Family jewels. With little glitter. But this is for you.
Now, don't even
this
put it on my desk, okay?
Let's just put it right there.
Can I just do it like this?
Let's just rub the desk down.
Rub the desk down with that. Just do that.
Isn't that nice?
What's that? Let me take that for you.
Do you want to have a hazmat crew come and handle
that? Yeah, put that into the pen. Hey, let me ask you something. You ever been an idiot for a day? You saw our idiots for a day, obviously. You saw our Swedish guy.
I've been an idiot for many days.
Yeah.
I actually had a similar experience once where I used to park cars as a valet.
Oh, okay.
And I took a van into a parking structure that was way too low for the clearance.
Oh, really?
And ripped the roof off of the van also. I also left someone else's keys in another car, and the people drove home about an hour away, and then the other people came out to get their car, but the keys were with the other people, and we had to track. I didn't get fired, though.
How did you not get fired after?
I have cat-like quickness.
Really? Have you ever been fired from a job?
I haven't been. I don't think so. I was a really extremely bad bank teller.
Really? You worked in a bank? You seem like the land. Like the corporate type.
No, I was. I was once pulled aside by the man. A customer asked to speak to the manager, and she said, "He is the worst teller that you have here. He is slow. He sweats." And I just stood there, thinking he's absolutely right. I can't protest this in any way. So I've been terrible at many things.
Wow.
That's why it's good to be here.
Yeah. But you're a runner. I know you're good at running.
I run. Yes, I run.
To just stop from being in fights and then you ran?
That's where the quickness comes in. Yeah.
But you ran the Boston Marathon.
I ran the Boston Marathon this year.
Okay, good.
I ran 3:56. 3 hours and 56 minutes.
Right, Well, that's good. Anything under 4 hours is pretty good.
And I had people, most Bostonians, with signs that said, "Frank the Tank," as I ran.
Oh, yeah.
I had people running in line, you know, next to me,
right.
Saying things like, "Hey, how about a cheer?" Trying to joke with me, and I really couldn't.
Well, yeah, it's hard when you're running.
I was sweating profusely along with bodily fluids coming out, and
wait a minute. There's just sweat
onto
when you
that
sweat.
G-string back it's not a place you really want to talk and joke around.
But now your wife also runs, right?
She does. Yeah, now, we ran the New York Marathon together.
And who's faster?
She's a little bit faster.
A little bit?
Yeah. She waited for me. And at a certain point in the marathon, you start getting a little irritable.
Yeah.
After 18 miles.
Right.
But she was having a great time. And we were running in New York, and she was like, "Honey, look, the Empire State Building." And I was like, "I know, we're in New York. Where else would it be?" That was not very nice.
A little testy.
A little testy. Yeah.
Now,
have you run a marathon ever?
I've driven a marathon. Yeah.
All 26 miles?
I don't have the 4 hours. You know? I mean, I could do it in 20 minutes, maybe. I'm just not a runner.
Yeah.
I tried running once in high school, the track.
Didn't work out?
No.
440?
220? I did run the 440, and I took off. And I was way ahead of everybody. I got halfway around, and everybody passed me.
Right,
and realized this isn't working. This isn't working. Look, I'll tell you what. We'll take a break. More with Will Ferrell right after this show.
Welcome back. Talking with
Wolf is a new movie. You know, I got to ask you something. I know your in-laws, yes. Your wife's parents, they're from Sweden, but they live here in the States.
Right.
They live in Boston,
right.
Kind of conservative area.
Right, right.
And what is he? He's like a cardiologist or something like that?
Right. Cardio.
Okay.
Radiologist.
Okay, when
yes.
they go to see their son-in-law,
it's very
yeah,
funny. It is.
They see them in the old school with the big ass naked on the screen. I mean, what do they say? Does that, do they comment on...
They comment, yes. they're slightly taken aback.
Were they yes. taken aback?
Comments from my mother, like my mother-in-law was like, oh my goodness. we saw the whole thing. And then my father's like, you were running naked, it's crazy. Really crazy. Oh my God, we loved it.
Oh no.
Yeah, so they a mixture
yeah.
of shock and awe,
well,
I call it.
Well,
yeah. Yeah.
Well, they're like Elf, because Elf's more of a family.
Elf's more of a family Kim. Movie with very little nudity.
Right. No nudity in
no
Elf.
No nudity whatsoever. No, it's...
You don't want to see a nude Elf.
No, you really don't, believe me.
Now, you shot this where, in Canada and New York?
We shot this in New York.
Yeah.
And we shot it up in Vancouver.
Okay.
The majority, which
yeah.
when I went up there to do some camera tests,
yeah.
we hadn't started principal photography, so I didn't have all my paperwork.
Right.
And they told me, well, just when you're going through customs, say you're here for pleasure. and you know, we'll worry about, they'll let you go, and
yeah.
so they said, "Why? I'm just here to visit some friends," and they go, "Well, can we look at your itinerary here?" And I forgot that it said Elf Productions on the top, so the guy, you would have thought I had 800 pounds of cocaine on me, because the guy was like, "Why are you give me the real reason why you're here? Because otherwise, you will never be allowed back in Canada again." I said, okay, we're just shooting a movie, and we haven't started yet, but I promise, when I have my paperwork, I'll come back and tell you. So I almost got barred from Canada
wow.
for life.
That's
so,
good.
Have your paperwork. That's
yeah,
the moral
yeah.
story. In life,
that's
generally.
That's embarrassing to get kicked out of Canada, because it's a friendly place.
It is
it's
friendly
a nice place.
Yeah. But somehow, I rubbed them the wrong way.
Yeah, well,
and I
want to. Well, lying
I want
at the
to
border.
Apologize
yeah,
to Canada if I
yeah.
could right now. I'm
yeah,
sorry.
Sure.
I'm sorry, polite Canadians.
Yeah. Now, James Caan, he plays your dad.
James Caan plays my father.
Right.
Bob Newhart is in the movie.
Yeah, Bob's funny.
James Caan put me in many a headlock.
Yeah.
He's a strong guy. He's still
yeah,
strong,
oh, yeah.
strong as an ox.
Yeah.
I like to say.
Yeah, strong as an ox.
Yes. When we wrapped the movie, I gave Jimmy a gift.
Yeah.
I gave him all three of the Godfather movies. And I said, I don't know if you're familiar with these. You may want to watch them.
Right.
One and two are a little slow.
Yeah.
But the third one really picks up steam.
Really, yeah. That's the good one.
I think you'll enjoy it.
Yeah. Now,
I don't know if he's ever seen them.
Really?
Yeah, to this day.
Yeah. Well, let me ask you about the Elf
yes,
costume.
Please.
I
costume.
See you. I saw the film.
Yes.
Very funny. But I see you actually shot in New York, because
right.
I see the New York. And you're walking around in the Elf costume.
I'm in
all through the whole movie. I'm just curious how New Yorkers react to a
yes,
large man
in
an Elf.
I'm basically in the movie in yellow tights, little pointy shoes,
okay.
green jacket, and a hat. So when we had to, you know, here I was walking, you know, in the Lincoln Tunnel with, you know, bus drivers. Give me that, and it was a mixture of either people completely ignored me as I was walking by them. They actually refused to make eye
Did
contact with me.
Did they pick up speed as you come?
Exactly,
and then pick up speed.
That would force me to want to chase them and try to hug them. And I made a lot of New Yorkers nervous. Or the opposite would be like, "Hey, SNL, nice tights." I got a lot of that.
Yeah.
Hey, SNL.
Well, let's show a clip. What is this scene we're going
oh,
to see?
This is basically.
Oh, this kind of way. This is where you find that where you find out you are not an actual elf, but a human.
Exactly. This is the moment where I find out.
This is where the acting begins. Let's take a look.
Enjoy.
I feel bad for the guy. I just hope he doesn't get wise. Well, he hasn't figured out he's a human by now. I don't think he ever will. He hasn't figured out he's human by now. I don't think he ever will.
I think they're too small.
I just
special.
Bring us down a whole pumpkin. You don't look so good, buddy. Are you okay?
I'll be okay. I just need a glass of water.
Buddy. There you go. Help opens November 7th. Well, thank you, buddy. Thank Will Ferrell. Be right back with Joe Rogan right after this. Fear Factor on NBC Monday Night at 8. Also co-hosts The Man Show on Comedy Central. Please welcome Joe Rogan. I got to ask you about this Fear Factor thing now.
Okay.
Lots of people try out for this show?
Yeah, 30,000. 30,000 a season.
How do you get rejected? I'm not being a smartass.
No,
I mean, I'm serious.
You have to have a serious medical problem or be really retarded. Like, regular retarded will take, but you have to have, like, real issues.
No, come on.
No?
I mean, the people, like, if they're too exuberant, oh, no, that's not what we want. I mean, what do they send you tapes?
No, we'll take exuberant. Exuberant's fine. Yeah, we just don't want you dying. You know, we just don't want you having a heart problem or...
Have you had any of those things where people... In the middle of a stunt?
No. We have had people that, you know, you would think were pretty healthy, but they failed the screening process. You know?
Okay. Now,
we've saved a couple of people.
The screening process.
Big bodybuilder dudes that had heart problems.
Yeah. Now, what is the screening process?
Well, they got to go through an EKG. They have to go through psychological examinations.
Now, what is that?
What's your question?
What's the psychological... I mean, if you're out there to eat, like, horse feces, what could they possibly... I mean, what do they ask you that... You know,
I don't know. I don't sit in on that.
No, you're not privy to that.
Yeah, that's very top secret.
And this is what, the fourth season?
This is the fourth season, which is unbelievable. I thought it was going to be canceled immediately, which is why I agreed to do it. You know, they call me up. They're like, they got the show going to sick dogs on people. I go, oh, yeah, I'll do that. Like, you guys are going to get sued. This is going to be fun. Four seasons later, I'm standing in front of a chick eating a plate of animal penises. I'm like, you can do it. Hang in there. Don't give up. And then I'm looking around, there's cameras, and I'm wearing makeup, and I'm like, what the hell did I do with my life that I wound up here?
Yeah, and plus, if she's doing that and you go out later, she can't go, I don't do that, you know. But
hey, listen, we're talking about animals, though.
That's right.
That's offensive.
Now what's the worst stunt you've seen?
Oh, there's no worse. They're all horrifying.
Yeah, well...
Especially the B stunts. The B stunts are all the gross ones.
So which
one? I mean, the B stunts, like the ABC.
Oh, okay.
The second stunt is always the disgusting one. And, you know, there's no worse one. I mean, I don't know.
I mean, is there something that you... is there something like... Everybody, some people are afraid of heights, some people... is there anything where you just...
For some reason, worms make me puke. I don't know what it is, but...
Worms?
The only time I've ever thrown up, and I didn't throw up actually on the set because I am a professional.
And that's the sign of a professional. When you don't throw up on
at
stage.
Work. You don't throw up at work. This is how jaded I am to all this. My girlfriend puked in her car. She was sick, she got sick, and she couldn't pull over. She was on the highway, and she threw up. She was so upset. She was like, oh, my God, I can't clean it because then I'm going to throw up. And I'm like, I'll clean it. Well, I don't care. I'm like, so used to seeing puke to me.
Yeah, that's your job.
Right. It's every day.
Will, the worst thing you've ever eaten, have you had any Fear Factor type moments?
Puke.
You ate puke?
Out of someone's car, yeah.
Really?
Why? I don't know, it's a good question.
Like, what do you say no to? Well, there are certain things they bring
to
you.
I don't say no to anything.
Oh, really?
You know, okay, that's why I'm hosting the show.
See, I don't wonder where you get 4 years of things to...
Well, NBC says no. Yeah. We don't have any standards, but fortunately NBC does, and they keep passing on several things. One of them was drinking urine. We wanted them to... Settle down. No cause for that.
Gee, I can't imagine why people would.
Well, I guess you can eat an animal's penis, but you're not allowed to drink urine. There's a line somewhere. I don't know where it is. But
now, this tape we have of this woman eating a bug.
Yeah.
This is pretty awful. And of course, on the show, you either win 50 grand or you get nothing.
Yes,
that's it.
Exactly.
Not even a lovely parting gift. That's it. Get out.
you know, you have a good time. And
yeah.
You get to
Does this need any setup, this woman?
I don't believe so. This is an African cave-dwelling spider that she had to eat. This is,
and it's alive.
Yeah, these are the nastiest looking things. They're like these evil crabs. They got these crazy little
let's
arms.
Let's take a walk. Here you go.
This is in Vegas.
Nothing bad's going to happen to you. The problem is you're thinking about it too much and you're freaking yourself out.
Do it. There you go. Get it. That's it. Get it. Get it.
To talk her into doing that. She just was not going to do it, but I just kept talking her into it.
Only 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Now, do you get letters of complaint that the people write in?
I don't read any letters. I just assume they hate us, so I just...
Now, the show has been picked up in other countries.
Deny. Yeah.
Isn't there a Mexican version?
Yes, there's a Mexican Fear Factor where the dude wears a cape. The guy wears the cape, and they'll just like, whatever. They got no safety standards at all. We did this one stunt where we had people in a burning building. We had, like, you know, fire hazard suits on and helmets and stuff. Right. They were wearing shorts. He went running through the fire. He had burns all over his legs, lost his hair. It was fantastic, you know? And it's all in Spanish, so it's even funnier.
It was great. I know you. You do the man show now.
Yes. Yeah.
Now, do you have any trouble with censors or anything on that?
We had a bunch of problems. The funniest one is we did a game show called, we wanted to do it called Make Me Hard. And what it is, and what it was is they have an electronic box attached to their crotch with a little light on it. When they get an erection, the light bulb goes off. The censor said that Make Me Hard was offensive. They said, let's change it to Make Me Stiff. Which makes tons of sense, since it's a word that means exactly the same thing with no confusion whatsoever. So that made a lot of people happy. And so, but here's the thing. We have these people doing all kinds of things. They have this electronic box on, you know, there's like naked girls dancing in front of them, bending over right in front of their face. And then we had this transsexual come out. And the transsexual looks like a real girl because she's taking the estrogen shots. And she's dancing. She licks his thighs. The guy's getting all excited. Then she pulls her pants down and whips out her penis, which I guess is okay. But don't say hard because people are going to get offended. They let us... We have tranny penis, but no hard. So, I don't know how they figure what's okay and what's not, but...
You know, I think you answered the question.
You think?
Yeah. I didn't see that episode.
I'll send you a tape.
Don't bother. I'm fine. Well, Joe, thank you very much.
Thanks,
it's Fear Factor, 8 o'clock. Be right back with Robert Randolph and the Family Band. My next guests kick off their national tour next Friday, October 24th, in Washington, D.C., at the 9:30 Club. Tonight, they're performing a song from the new CD, Unclassified. I think I said Rudolph before, and I apologize. I apologize for that. Please welcome Robert Randolph and the Family Band.
Love.
Just growing. Look how we stand.
Nice work. That was great, you guys. That was terrific. Robert Rudolph. Rudolph, I said it again. Randolph. Randolph. I'm thinking Jimi Hendrix.
That's all right.
I want to thank all my guests. Come on in, you guys. Joe Rogan, Fear Factor, of course. Thank you very much. And, of course, Will Ferrell, Elf, is the new movie. It opens November 7th. Stay tuned for Conan. Coming up next. Nice work once
thank
again,
you.
Buddy.
Thank
Have
you.
A good weekend, everybody. See you Monday.
Vi fortsätter strax med nattfilm. Martin Scorseses drama King of Comedy med Robert De Niro och Jerry Lewis.